Hi all, my name's Tom, and I bring to your attention two very serious matters. The very first one involves a friend of mine and a friend of yours, unless you're working for the dark side. His name is Mr. Ebert. Mr. Ebert and his family are under threat of eviction by the bailiffs, and that's tomorrow. I'll give you the full address right now, and so if you've got a pen, please jot it down. It's 66 Woodville Road, and that's in Golders Green in London. And it's NW11 9TN. That's at 8 o'clock in the morning. This man works tirelessly for people from 4 or 5 in the morning to 10 or 11 at night, and he's in his 70s. So it's time to pay back a little that Mr. Ebert has given others. So if you can come along, his family and himself will be very grateful. Now, to take you up to speed of the fraud that's been perpetrated on his family and him, I've got this warrant, and we know that the warrant is fraudulent, but I'll come to that in a moment. We have discovered they tried to perpetrate another crime on him. They got a warrant for his arrest for not paying a fine. We checked. The court has never heard of this fine and have never issued a warrant. We believe this warrant came out of the bailiff's office. This was a trick to arrest Mr. Ebert and take him away from his home so his home can be possessed. Now, this came to light when a group of us had a meeting. Now, our group represent 10 to 12 people. We come from all over the country, from Yorkshire, Wales, East and West Midlands, home counties, London. We come from all over. There's men and women, black and white, and every major religion is represented. So we're not just a bunch of grumpled people who can't pay their bills. We are serious about what we are doing. We discussed on the 12th of November what was happening to the people of these islands. And what we discovered, or what we agreed to, is it was terrorism. People are being robbed of their goods. Their property has been stolen. They're being put on the streets. Families are breaking up, and in severe cases, people are taking their lives. And many have taken their lives this year. This is terrorism on a commercial scale. This is homegrown terrorism. So David Cameron bangs on about terrorism. It's right before our eyes, and he must know what's happening. If not, he's got an election coming up. Let's let him know what's happening. The warrant for his arrest was flagged up, and the reason is we contacted MI5 to notify them of terrorist activities, and they told us to go to the Metropolitan Police and speak to them. It's precisely what we did, and we were treated very well there and taken very seriously, and they sent for a fraud investigator who took down all the details, and we were all interviewed. We presented him with all our documentation proving fraud, and we told him it takes 10 minutes to actually prove this fraud. All you need to do is go to the court and seize the likes of my file or any one of us that was there, our files, and request and see the documents that we say should be there, and we know they don't because most of us have seen our files. But you're not getting that privilege now because of what we've been doing. They're restricting you to see files and even file documents into the court. They are stopping us at every turn now. They are absolutely panicking. What we told the officer to look for was an order for possession. A request for possession. For a warrant, I should say. That is something you never find in your documents. We can find them, but never filled out. The process is you make your request for a warrant, then you pay your fee. None of us have had a fee paid, and we've never seen one out of hundreds we've looked at. And number two, the judge must give an order for a warrant. That's why you don't get the warrant signed, because the judge doesn't order them, they simply issue them. So it's a fraudulent document. The easiest way to describe it is as the warrant makes its journey from the court to the so-called debtor's home, it'd be like taking a bus ride. When you go on a journey with a bus, you go and request a ticket, as you would request a warrant. Then you would pay for your ticket. Then you would pay for your warrant. Then you would go to the bus driver or conductor, and he would order you, if your paperwork is all correct, to go inside and sit down. If the paper is all correct with the warrant and it's been paid, the judge would order a warrant, and both you and the warrant would make that journey to where your destination is. That would be perfectly correct, and this procedure that they are supposed to stick to strictly. This they do not. The officer knows what to do, and he assures us that should the bailiff turn up at Mr. Ebert's without the correct documentation, he will be arrested. The other thing that he was shocked at, he didn't get access to Mr. Ebert's arrest warrant. The judge said he was not granting permission to see it. And just a few days earlier, Guy Taylor had the same problem. The CPS sent him a document, and he opened it up, and lo and behold, in there, the CPS had requested from the court the documentation, the file of Guy Taylor, which is a criminal investigation, and the judge gave an order that the CPS could not access the file. And the reason being is there is no documents in there. So that's a fraud. How bad the fraud is, I printed this off the internet 5 minutes ago. This is a warrant for possession of land. Okay, you can print these off the internet. As you can see, it's all blank. It's a proper one. These are the ones that they say we won't give you in case you fill them out. As you can see on the right hand side, or be your left hand side, I believe, you will see that it's addressed to the debtor. So this warrant is for the person who has been evicted. And that's the instructions they're supposed to follow, so that they comply with the court. And it's such a good document that they even supply a county court seal already printed for you. You can print this off the internet. Maybe I should fill it in and put 10 Downing Street and go and ask the bobbies on the door to assist me to take the property off David Cameron, because it's just as official as their one. The fraud is on a commercial scale. It's horrendous. So this is just a short video. By the way, if he does turn up with something like this, the actual act that the county court act that he would be prosecuted in, under is section 138. It's a penalty for falsely pretending to act under the authority of a court. Any person who delivers or causes to deliver to any persons any papers falsely purporting to be a copy of a warrant, summons, or other process of the county court, knowing it to be false. Well, it is false, because when they get these things and they're outside your home, they hide them from you. They'll never show you. They'll turn a bit over and go, that, there we go. It's got a seal on it. It's official. Well, if he does turn up, it says he shall be guilty of an offence and shall, for each offence, be liable on conviction, on indictment, to imprisonment of a term not exceeding 7 years. It's exactly the same as a judge should get. And that's under statutes, because the abuse of a statutory process or statutory power is, once again, a 7-year jail sentence, because it's a common law criminal offence. These people are criminals. We shall see what the Metropolitan Police do from here. Now, I hope they all take notice of this little video, because there's other ones going out and there will be press releases. So this is just a call to arms. Well, not arms, solidarity for Mr. Ebert, and to put you in notice of the criminality that we're discovering. We all knew they were criminals, but to this degree, it's horrendous. So, thank you for listening. Get along to Mr. Ebert's and show them. Common law is a higher law than their pretend laws. Take care now. Bye.